Hello, and welcome back to Sailwind. When we last left off, we were heading to Nilan from Golden Rock City with our supplies. So, with that in mind, there is an island over there. I think that might be it. Or is that the Isle of Clear Mind? Well, let's take a look. That's directly to the north. There's definitely something to the southwest. I wonder if that looks too big. Oh, and then there's one down there too. Let's take a look at that one. That one is directly south of us. Okay, so that means I think it's because we've been attacking. Yeah, so that island is directly in that direction. It's directly towards the wind, unfortunately. Well, maybe not. Okay, so let's head back. What we will do is we'll bring this in a little bit just to tighten up the sheet, because we're going to swing the boat. Past here. And hopefully we'll have enough forward momentum to actually tack across here. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Just a little more. There we go. Okay, so let's check our wind. Yeah, that's pretty good. Let's open this up a little bit. Like that. Ah, everything looks good. Okay. So I think we got a little bit off track because of the wind, and we might have drifted a little too far north. So while we're at it, we still have 6 goat cheese, 33 drinks of water, 39 fishing hooks. We are, let's see, we are a little tired, but on drinks and food we're pretty good. So do we want to try fishing again? I don't really need to eat anything right now. I think I might be able to go directly there. I think we have enough. Yeah. So let's take a look at this. Yeah, that's pretty good. Just making sure the anchor's up. Yeah, the anchor's up. Okay. Everything looks good. We're making our way as fast as we can. Well, we still got two days to go to Al Nilan. I do not know for the life of me why I have such difficulty saying that name. Al Mullen? Anyway, let's fish. I kind of wish we could, like, there would be a way to, pick up a fishing hook while you were holding the rod. Alright, so let's give this a whirl. There we go. Now, I always pull it back in just a little bit, just to keep it relatively close. Part of the problem is if the bobber is really far away, it's kind of a pain bringing it back in. So, really the bobber only has to be in the water, so. Yeah, fishy, fishy, fishy. Ah, there we go. Just want to keep it nice and taut, but not bend this down too much. If there's too much tension on the line, the fish will throw the hook. Okay, that's pretty close. That's also pretty close to me. We must be getting close. Yep, there he is. Okay. Dropped the fish. Oh, and he kept the hook on the line. Very nice. Very, very, very nice. So sometimes, and I'm not sure exactly what what determines whether the fish uses up the hook or not. I suspect that it might be just random, like sometimes it does and sometimes it doesn't. But here, let's give this a whirl. Bring the line in just a little bit. Oh, look at that. We've already got one. Careful, careful. Not too quick. Just want to make sure that it's tight enough that you're bringing it in, but not too tight. Otherwise, it will snap. Another one of these blue shimmer fish, I think. Oh, we still have the hook. Look at that. Let's go again. I don't think I am anywhere near the island yet. It's going to be a little while, so. See if we could catch another one. Apparently, from what I've heard, are like eels and everything. But that might actually be out in the ocean, I'm not sure. I have not yet seen an eel. You're fishy, fishy, fishy. Okay. Oh, this one's taking a little while. Now, I have done this thing where I let go of the pole, and it actually stands upright, which is weird. I think that's a bug. But then all of a sudden, like, the fish catches it, and it will just take the rod and reel right off the boat. So, let's not do that. I don't know if there's any plans to put, like, those the round cylinder holders on the boat. That might be a little much, just because if you happen to get two fish at the same time, it might be a little much. So, wow. Like, no fish. Gonna let the line out just a little bit. Just in case the bobber is, you know, bobbing up and down on the ocean or something. Well, thankfully the weather is nice. Whoa, there we go. Another blue shimmerfish. I think that's what they're called. Alright, he took the hook that time. So, I'm gonna just drop this. Let's see. Oh, it doesn't actually have a name for them. I could stand to eat something. Now, because we're not cooking these guys, they're not really going to give us that much. But, hey, that's pretty good. We'll just save that guy for later. Whoa, we are close. And something tells me that we probably need to spin this way. Oh, this is going to be close, folks. Nope, that's the wrong way. There we go. Okay. Let's keep spinning it. Wow, I didn't realize we were that close. See, the funny thing is when you're out to sea, you're not really close to the islands, you don't really get a good indication of how fast you're really going. It's hard to tell because, you know, you're out, there's no point of reference. So, okay. Actually, I'm going to lift this up just a little bit so I can see easier. Alright, so let's take a look at our wind. Oh, our wind is pretty good. Okay. I think we could stand to open this up just a little bit more. Now, I'm assuming that the dock is in this direction because that's where the town is. So hopefully. Hopefully we'll be able to hopefully that's where the town is. The towns are not really marked on the map. Yeah, see, they're not really marked on the map too well. But usually when you approach them, you can tell based upon based upon where the, you know, the structures, where you can see the structures. Okay, so we're gonna have to swing in here, I think. So let's see. Yeah, that's kind of the direction we gotta go in, so. Just want to get past this point right here. And then hopefully. Pretty close to heading in directly into the wind. When we get past this point right here, we're going to have to. We might try swinging out to the starboard, to the right a little bit, and then making a quick swing. That way we gain a little bit of speed before we tack or jib or jibe or whatever that's called. I'll figure that out. Everybody in the comments is now, wow! But basically, to swing the sail to the other side and get through the part where you're facing directly into the wind, the irons, as it were. So, all right, we're just about through here. Still have hours of sunlight left, which is nice. Okay. Yeah, that's definitely where the town is. Okay, so let's pull this in just a little bit. We will swing out this way for just a bit. Pick up a little bit of speed. Up just a bit. Let's open this up. And then we're going to swing this way. Now you'll hear the flapping for when we're right in the irons, and then it's going to flip to the other side. And now we should start picking up. Yeah, we're picking up the wind here. I'm gonna keep going until I actually see the land. There it is. All right. So now, can open this up again. Let's check our. Oh, our wind is good. Actually, we could probably increase that a little bit. Okay, so if you look at the corner. one over my eye, you can see the four pilings over there. That's to show where the sandbars are. I'm pretty sure the wind is actually blowing. Okay, there's the dock right there. Which kind of happens to be where the wind is blowing, but let's try to approach. Look at how difficult it is to pull this in. Okay. We're going to lift the sail up a little bit, just to slow us down just a bit. Oops. Okay. Getting pushed backwards by the wind. So let's tighten this up anymore. Okay. We will loosen so that the wind can actually start pushing us backwards. This way. Okay. And we'll tighten it up. Ah, getting tired. See, we're just skirting. Okay, so here's what we want to do. We want to open this up. Nope, not like that. Like this. Just barely making it away. Okay. Okay, so with this momentum, I'm going to try to swing back out again. Come on, come on. It picks up the wind on this side. We can just make it past that spot where the wind, there we go, where the wind gets into the sail just a little bit, and then we're going to start moving. Okay. A minute we start heading to the dock, everything's going to slow down. Because we're basically going to be running into the wind. Let's jump onto here. Let's grab the back one. Whoops. I missed the dock. Let's get back up on the boat again. Let's see if this actually works. Yes, I think it will. Ah, the mooring lines are very, very, very forgiving. So while that's doing its thing, I am going to unload our ship here. Those are my dates. That's my goat cheese. Dates. Here we go. Goods. It's probably good that we docked here because it looks like a storm is coming through. You can tell, just look at the water. When the waves start doing that little dance, that's when you know. Wind's starting to pick up, the clouds are starting to come in. Okay. Both quests are complete. Let's see how much money we have. 355. The vendor still out? Probably not. Nope. I just missed the vendors. But that's okay because we have to rest. So, there are no accommodations in the town yet, so we are going to rest. But before we do, we could probably eat this fish. Okay, and then we should drink some drink. Head to the hammock and we will sleep. And basically we'll sleep the whole night away. And then at that point, I think we're going to call it a video. Because now we're in Al-Nalem. We have delivered all of our cargo. And we can choose to sell our dates and see if they'll give us any sort of good profit. We can try to pick up some cargo here. We can try to pick up some trade missions here. So the quests, the missions, they give you the stuff to transport and you get paid to transport, but you're not actually like buying and selling. For the cargo stuff, then you're actually doing the trading. So you're buying something at one port and then selling it at another port, hopefully for a profit. So now that we have the fishing pole and fishing hooks, we can fish for our food, although I would like to try to get enough money to get a grill. I think that would be incredibly helpful. So it's still pretty dark out. Let's keep resting. And this way we'll have full energy. Okay. There we go. So now it's dawn, I would imagine. Yep, it's dawn. We should probably eat and drink a little bit. Gosh darn it. There we go. Okay. I'm going to pick up the fishing pole to put it in my inventory. Here's dates. What's that out here? I don't know if they sell dates here. If they do, we probably shouldn't sell. I'll tell you what, let's get everything. Yes, they do. 116, is that good? Probably not. I think we'll keep our dates. They'll be an extra food source for us. Now, the goat cheese might actually be worth something, because I don't think I've seen people selling goat cheese, but not like the giant boxes of them. So I'm wondering. We'll just keep it. All right. Let's look at quests. First of all, we're going to... Whoops. Let's get back in the boat. Okay, the wind is blowing west. The wind is blowing west, so we don't want to go back to Gold Rock City. That would be bad. It would be a pain in the neck. So let's take a look. Maybe we'll see if there's anything that sends us to the academy. Speaking of which, or we could go to Alchemist's Island. Wow, I've got two of them that go to Alchemist's Island. Or we could go to Albacore. Okay, so this is 231. 231 plus 192. How many is this? Oh, that is one. Speaking of which, if I go into my log, let me check my reputation. I can actually take three missions. So, let's go with this. Let's go Alchemist's Island. Take that. Coconuts to Albacore Town. That's 308. Oh, two boxes for 308. Coconuts to Alchemist's Island. Set. Okay, let's go. Coconuts to Albacore Town. Set. Okay. Alright, we will load these up, and then we're going to call it a video. Alright, there's one. Biggest problem with this starter boat is the fact that it is so small. It just feels like I can barely carry anything, but okay, so there's two. Let's just make sure this is copper. That's coconut to Albacore Town, so drop this in here. Like yay. And then the copper will be smack in the middle. And I would imagine copper is probably pretty heavy. And so if there's weight stuff, which I imagine that there is. Oh, here's my dates. Put the dates back here. Okay. And so now we're ready to go. So next video, we will leave here. We'll head southeast of Al-Malem and head to Alchemist's Island and then on to Albacore Town. So, with that in mind, I will see you next time. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like the video, if you like it, and if you want me to do more, and I will see you in the next video.